To answer this question, the keyword here is stock up. Now, when you stock up, you want to stock up things that you sell the most or you sell the least?
Most,
right? That means you want to stock up things that you sell the most or the best seller, right? Now, if you want to stock up things that you sell the most, you want to, okay, by looking at these three things, which one will you stock up? 15 cm, right? You will stock up this. You will stock up this because this 15 cm you need. You sell 14 pieces in 1 week, right? But then, if I calculate the mean, then I realize that I need to stock up this. So, is it correct?
Wrong.
That's why he said, instead of using mean, which other one should I use? So the answer is
mode.
So you support, use a reason to support. So what they're asking is, they're asking why mode? Why not mean or median?
Because not accurate.
Is it accurate?
No,
is it accurate?
No.
No,
then I get correct.
Yeah, you get correct. Oh, okay. Good lah, good. But other than accurate, what other things should we say? Because mode will tell us the one that is most frequent, right? Most sold. So in this case, it's the 15 cm. Can follow how to answer the reason? Now, okay, can. Now, next. Now, she represented the data in this. So in this 15 cm, I sell 14. Do you see? So I have 1, I have 2, I have 3. Okay? These are the 3 data. Do you know how to read this data? So for 15 cm, I sell 14. For 20, I sell 4. For 30, I sell 7. But then it says, why this is inappropriate? Now, I know you have written your answer, but what does your answer mean?
She never sell 1 cm to 14.
She never sell 1 cm to 14 cm. This one don't have, right? This one don't have, right? What is the only one I have? 5, 20, and 30. No, 15, 20, and 30. So in this case, can I represent in these lines?
Yes.
No.
Because if I represent in this line, what happened? I may be able to read. If I want to sell 10 cm ruler, I will sell 9 ruler. I will sell 9 pieces of 10 cm ruler. Based on the graph, right?
Yeah.
But what's the problem here? Is there any 10 cm ruler?
No.
Don't have. So that's why this is inappropriate. You understand now? Why this is inappropriate? Because there's no such thing as 5 cm ruler, 10 cm ruler, don't have. In the bookshop, there's only 3 types of ruler, 15, 20, and 30. There's no 25. So you shouldn't use a line graph. So all these are wrong. Can follow? So that's why you copy it down. Then suggest a representation that you should use. Then the rest that you have copied down, right? Now, then I mentioned to you the difference between bar graph and histogram. Then I ask you all, still remember the difference? You all say not so. So what's the difference between bar graph and histogram?
Bar graph is
bar. Bar is not connected. Histogram is
connected.
Okay. Now, is it true that I can use both interchangeably?
Yeah. No.
Answer is no. Okay, let me give example of when to use this, when to use this. Now, for example, I want to check iPhone, Xiaomi, Samsung, or Oppo. Now, you see these three, are they related in the scale?
No.
Can I say iPhone and Xiaomi? iPhone should be next to Xiaomi. Are they continuous?
No.
No, right? So if they're not continuous, so I write the keyword. The keyword here is this is not continuous. Then you should use bar chart. So no link, no link, no link. So they are isolated. Then what about the histogram? Histogram means this thing here, the number makes sense one. For example, this is 2001. This one is 2002. This is 2003. Like it is one after the other. Or this is not so good example. This one, I can also represent this as bar chart, right? 2001, 1 bar. 2002, space, 1 bar. So how do I represent this? Oh, I know already. For example, the height. Now, is height continuous? Example, if I say, I erase this because this example not so good. If I say, let's try. This is 150, this is 160. What does this bar mean? 150 to 160. But here to here will be what? 160 to 170. Can you see that it's continuous? So the number is running in order one. Then in this case, we don't use bar chart. What do we use? Histogram. We use the one that is joined together. Now can follow? So I zoom out. So now you see there are two types. One is bar graph, one is histogram. So now know what to use what. I hope you come out this year, then at least the 14 of us will get full mark. Yay! Okay, stop the video here.